Meanwhile, on the broader markets at this hour, joining us now is Jurrien Timmer, Director of Global Macro for Fidelity Investments Global Asset Allocation Division. And here on set with us, David Bahnsen, Chief Investment Officer of the Bahnsen Group. David, I'm just considering some of your thoughts on this. We did go through a period where all stocks could do is go up. It was about a year, I think, until February of this year. And it's been different, choppy, volatile, haven't really made any headway. And that, I think you attribute that to normalization of interest rates, that's going to happen. That we blame it on the news cycle, but it has more to do with globally just resetting in terms of an environment where rates are headed up, not down.
It can't be the news cycle. I mean, the Fed is by far the best explanation here as far as the underlying skittishness in the market, that just resurgence of volatility. First of all, we were just not volatile enough for all of last year. But that rally you're talking about where things just kept going up, couldn't go down, it actually started the last time I was on set with you, the day after Brexit in mid-2016, lasted a year and a half. And what changed at the end of January was what? All of a sudden, the Mueller investigation? No, that was a year earlier, 8 months earlier. All of a sudden, President Trump talking a little protectionist? That had gone on through the whole campaign. The only thing that's really changed is the fact that rates are moving higher and they've begun normalizing the balance sheet. I think it's just creating a paradigm of a little more volatility, which I also think is healthy.
Why shouldn't this resolve itself positively, though, since it's sooner or later the Fed had to do this anyway? Is there a notion that they'll overshoot or screw it up or go
too fast? Well, first of all, Joe, they will overshoot. That's what they always do. But that's probably a ways down the line. In the meantime, I would agree. I think it will resolve itself positively. And the whole issue that I don't understand why we're not talking about more with this earnings season, and it's actually the reason that Home Depot is down, because they've bucked the trend. Revenue growth this quarter cannot be credited to tax reform. Tax reform doesn't allow revenues to grow. It allows earnings to grow.
It could eventually, theoretically.
Well, I think from CapEx and those other
consumers have more than
that. In fact, I think it very much will. And that is a lot of the thesis that we would have to be bullish right now over the next 6 to 18 months, is that CapEx growth will lead to more productivity, more revenue. But in the meantime, earnings growth, and I think the overall acceptance that the economy is growing at a good pace will allow equities to recover. I just don't think that will happen across the board. I think the overpriced stuff will have to be repriced, and so that's why we're anti-FANG and pro-value.
Living here, I'm not feeling real flush right now. Had to ramp up my withholding. I got no, right? I mean, for being pretty well off in general. I'm supposed to be like the rich guy that got the big tax break.
See, I moved to Manhattan to get a tax cut.
Yeah. It backfired for us, didn't it, Sorkin? A little bit, sort of.
I agree.
That's okay. Not complaining. Anyway, are you an inflation hawk? What's your story? What's bugging you today?
Everything is fine, actually. You know, the fact that the market is only going sideways while evaluation sort of vertigo is being corrected, I think is actually a very good outcome. And I agree with David. You know, the market's driven by two things, earnings and interest rates. Those two things drive valuations. And for the last 9 years, you know, earnings more than doubled, but the PE more than doubled, and therefore price quadrupled. So it's been an epic run. And just in the last 2 years, the S&P, until January at least, the S&P was up 52% against record low volatility. So the market kind of got ahead of itself. Interest rates are rising. You know, we have kind of a double whammy of low rates and low risk premia across all asset classes. And that's kind of a tough hurdle to overcome. And this is why the market, I think, is not rewarding the 24% earnings growth that we saw in Q1 and likely 20 to 22% in Q2 and Q3. Markets generally don't reward earnings growth that is that high because it's not considered sustainable. So we're just having a reset, and my sense is that it's a benign reset. You know, the PE is already down 3 points since January, and the S&P is down, you know, less than 10%. I'll chalk that up as a win, and I kind of liken it to the late 2014, early 2016 period where the market just sat around and did nothing. And, you know, that's a pretty good outcome because markets don't go up in a straight line. They never have. They probably never will. So the question is, when you correct a very, lopsided advance, you can do it through price or through time. And we seem to be doing this through time. And certainly the earnings backdrop is providing a very large bailout, if you will, for PE levels that just got too high back in January.
You dated to Brexit, which you did, David. I mean, that's 40. We had a 40% move, yeah, basically, didn't we? I mean, the reversion to the mean just means...
That's right. And if you go to the bottom level of Brexit, 40% with the lowest amount of drawdown in market history. So you had the combination of a really big run with extraordinary low volatility. And he talked about risk premia. That's the risk premia investors are looking for. The higher volatility creates that. So right now, I just think it's sort of a little awakening as to how this stuff is supposed to work. But if we think a flat market is going to continue for a little while, choppiness, it does behoove people to try to get paid through the dividend growth approach that we take. I think that you're seeing the highest level of dividend increases that we've seen in 20 years so far this year. And that's not being reflected in stock prices, but it is creating cash to investors.
If we're going to have, at least for the near term, let's say 5 years, is the lower interest rate environment overall, right? I mean, because the terminal Fed target now is like half of what it was in the 80s and 90s.
And it's not going higher than that in your lifetime or mine.
Well, that means that are we still stuck with a long-term annual gain of 7%, 6%, 7% in equities, or could you get annually 10%.
In a nominal basis, higher than that. On a real basis, that would be about what you would expect.